tonight. You can have your way. Not our will, may yours be done. Come and change us. Not our will, may yours be done. Come sustain us. Dwell in the midst of us. Wipe all the tears from our faces. Dwell in the midst of us. Tears from my faces, dwell in the midst of us. You can have your way.
Have your way. You can have your way.
You can have your way.
Why don't you just pray that with us?
You can have your way.
Have your way.
Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you for an opportunity, Lord, to come in and to celebrate the birth of your Son. Lord, thank you for coming and dwelling among us. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you that you've given us the ability, Lord, to sense in our spirit when you're here and when you're not. Lord, we sense your glorious presence here. And I pray, Father, that as we read the story again and as we sing the songs again, that Holy Spirit, you'll come in and you'll dwell in and inhabit every part of this service tonight, Lord. Lord God, I thank you for encouraging and lifting up hearts that might be, Lord, missing some loved ones tonight. I thank you, Lord, that the peace that the angels sang that first night, Lord, is here tonight. Lord, just let your peace fill this house. Hallelujah. Come on, pray with me, church. Lord, let your peace fill this place. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let your peace fill every heart, every mind. And in the place of stress, Lord, I pray that the joy that you came to bring, Lord Jesus, will fill every heart. Let your joy fill the house. Yeah. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. Thank you. Well, happy Christmas Eve. We would say in my family, it was a big deal. Everybody, the first one to get up and say, Christmas Eve gift. Does anybody else do that? A few of you, yeah. So, you know, if you want to know where that started, I wrote a story about it. Just, you know, nobody could tell me in my family, where did this come from? I'm like, well, I'll write a story and we'll make it up. We'll, because if you don't know, I'll tell you where it came from. It's what some of the things that I used to do when both sides of our families would get together for Christmas was I would write stories, family folk stories. You know, there might be just a little bit of thread of a truth there, and I would not embellish. That's the word I'm looking for. I would just embellish it a little bit, and it became family history. Amen. So I want to welcome you. I thank everybody that's coming is here. Glory to God. Good to see you on this Christmas Eve 2022. Amen. Did y'all, anybody have any broken pipes? Is everybody good? Well, I've only fixed, you had some? Are you fixed? Okay, we got to get over to Sister Aretha. Somebody else. You got, y'all need to learn to call me. Is that here in town? All right, you need to talk to me after service, all right? We're gonna take care of this broken pipes. That's no good. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. Ryan and Sarah? Well, bummer. All right. I don't know that I can help with the sewer. So what we're going to do tonight, I've contacted several families, and we're going to have families come up and do the reading, and then they'll lead us in the song that we're going to sing, and then I'm going to narrate just a little bit as we do. So for our first song tonight, the Waldrop family is going to come, and they're going to sing. Amen. Come on up here. They don't have far to go. They're right on the front row. We've got another mic over here, too. Y'all want to? Yeah, there you go. Not trying to split the family up or nothing, but amen. It would help if we turn this on. Is everything on? There you go. Right there. Ready?
Okay. Be
to read.
You have enlarged the nation and increased its joy. The people have rejoiced before you as they rejoice at harvest time and as they rejoice when dividing spoils. For you have shattered their oppressive yoke and the rod on their shoulders, the staff of their oppressor, just as you did on the day of Midian. For the trampling boot of battle and the bloodied garments of war will be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child will be born for us, a son will be given to us, and the government shall be on his shoulders. He will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. The dominion will be vast, and its prosperity will never end. He will reign on the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish and sustain it with justice and righteousness from now on and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will accomplish this.
Amen. 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 Thank you, guys. Hallelujah. You know, the birth of Christ that resulted in the redemption of man. Go ahead. You can clap. It's all right. The birth of Christ that resulted in the redemption of man was not an afterthought in the mind of God. Rather, it was the culmination, as Isaiah said, of the plan of God that was established before he ever spoke those words, "Let there be light." Prophets foretold his coming birth, his miracles, and the effect of his life and his torturous death. This is the reason for the season, guys. Amen. God's plan is to confirm his love for mankind. And so we're going to look a little closer at those events that happened that night. I don't think I've ever done this. I had this written out in 2014, but I don't think I did it this way. Any of y'all ever read that book, This Present Darkness? You know, it kind of gave you just a little different look into the spirit realm. And so we're going to look at Christmas through those eyes, all right? From man's perspective, this day was really all about visitations. The angel Gabriel visits Zechariah in the temple and tells him, "You're going to have a son." God visits Elizabeth and she becomes pregnant with John the Baptist. The angel Gabriel then visits Mary and announces the birth of Christ. The Holy Spirit comes down and overshadows or visited Mary. And though a virgin, she becomes pregnant with the living word of God. Angels visit Joseph in a dream and tell him it's okay to take her as your wife. Mary then visits Elizabeth, and the life in Elizabeth awakens to the visitation of the yet unborn life in Mary. Yes, I did say, even in the womb, Jesus was alive. Angels visit Joseph in a dream. Oh, I'm sorry, I skipped down there. Where was I? Mary and Joseph visit Bethlehem. Angels visit shepherds. Shepherds visit the manger. Wise men visit the Christ child. Angels visit Joseph again in a dream and warn him to leave for Egypt. Jesus visits Egypt with his parents, and ultimately he stands looking over Jerusalem and says, "This is your day of visitation, that it's come for all of Israel." And sadly, most missed it. Amen. How many of you are praying for a visitation tonight? Amen. That we pray, we believe that you know, we need an awakening in this land. Well, guess what? If there's going to be an awakening in the land, then Jesus is going to have to show up for a visit. Amen. In the scriptures, we're told to watch and pray. We're to watch for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we need to take care. We need to watch and pray, for you too may miss your day of visitation if you're not careful. Now, that's what we see as we read through the Christmas story from the earthly perspective. But when we look at it from heaven's perspective, it's a little different. From heaven's perspective, it's a day of fulfillment, a day of completion, and a day of war. Amen? The Ancient of Days announces to the host of heaven that the day of visitation for Israel has come. I want you to just to see how it must have been looking, visiting into heaven and watching these things come to pass. Immediately, the plan of all ages was put into motion. The plan, known only in parts by the inhabitants of the glories of heaven, but was about to become fully revealed. A single flash of light, I kind of stole that from This Present Darkness. A single flash of light descends to that little blue planet called Earth. It was Gabriel, and he was carrying an announcement to an aging priest that the plan had been activated. Woo! Come on. I want you to look at it that way. There's gonna come a time when God hits, okay, now. The plan is gonna be activated. Folks, I believe he might have already pushed that button. Amen. And Jesus is going to come back to earth again. The plan of all the ages was put into motion. The plan, known only in parts by the inhabitants of the glories of heaven, was about to become fully revealed. A single flash of light descended to the blue planet called Earth. I'm going to have to stay up with this. Carrying the announcement to an aging priest that the plan had been activated. He would have a son that would prepare the way for the Messiah. The host of heaven watched as several flurries of light flashed from the planet below as the glorious being called Gabriel moved from one assignment to the next. We're getting a picture of what it looks like from heaven to watch this occur. Amen. We have now the Gregory family is going to come up and do some readings and singing. Man, you ought to go stand with your dad. We kind of set this up difficult. I'm sorry. Why don't we read first?
Yeah.
Read first. Read it, Dad.
Luke 1:11 says, "While Zechariah was in the sanctuary, an angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing to the right of the incense altar. Zechariah was shaken and overwhelmed with fear when he saw him. But the angel said, 'Don't be afraid, Zechariah. God has heard your prayer. Your wife Elizabeth will give you a son, and you are to name him John. You will have great joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be the great in the eyes of the Lord. He must never touch wine or other alcoholic drinks. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit even before his birth, and he will turn many Israelites to the Lord their God. He will be a man with the spirit and power of Elijah. He will prepare the people for the coming of the Lord. He will turn the hearts of the fathers to their children, and he will cause those who are rebellious to accept the wisdom of the godly."
That's John. Go ahead.
Luke 1:26 through 38. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent an angel, Gabriel, to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you." Confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think what the angel could mean. "Don't be afraid, Mary," the angel told her, "for you have found favor with God.
Yes.
You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be very great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will reign over Israel forever. His kingdom will never end." Mary asked the angel, "But how can this happen? I am a virgin." The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. What's more, your relative Elizabeth had become pregnant in her old age. People used to say she was barren, but she conceived a son and is now in her sixth month.
Amen.
For the word of God will never fail." Mary responded, "I am the Lord's servant. May everything you have said about me come true." And then the angel left her.
Stars are brightly shining.
Oh, no.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you. What a night that must have been. Amen. The angel goes to John. I tell you what hit me. I really just sensed that just the Holy Spirit really point out that one part of the verse. Elizabeth used to be called barren. What did you used to be called before he showed up? Come on. Before your day of visitation, what did they call you? They don't call you that anymore. Oh, come on, church. This is Christmas Eve, but can we have church too? Amen, amen. Occasionally, from the spiritual view, occasionally faced with opposition from the prince of darkness, but never kept from his duties, Gabriel completes the task of prophetic declaration and returns to await the next stage of the plan. From their superior vantage point, the host of heaven could see movement in the realm of darkness as the Luciferian host attempted to discern just what the Ancient of Days was up to now. They whispered and eavesdropped on conversations trying to counter heaven's every move. The journey of the wise men would have gone completely unnoticed had there not been a familiar spirit hanging around Herod's palace. And now as Herod's scribes turned to the scriptures to determine the birthplace of the Messiah, this demon was already reporting to Lucifer the result of their search. Bethlehem was to be ground zero. Amen. The Otis family is going to come read and sing for us. They're looking at each other like, say what? Yeah, read first.
Hold on, I'm getting all these do I love the Bible apps. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house of the line of David, and went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Amen. Ready?
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels shine? When you've kissed your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Thank you.
Amen. Woo! Thank you. You know, I've heard people make fun of that song, but I'm telling you what, when you look at it from heaven's perspective, you know that it was a whole lot more, about a whole lot more than just a baby being born in a stable somewhere. This was heaven's plan to rescue, to redeem you and me from the hand of the enemy. It's a reason we celebrate. Amen. It's not just the baby. It is why he came. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mary, did you know? She didn't know, but he sure showed her eventually. But even as the prince of darkness was releasing his plan to counteract the promised birth by killing all of the male children 2 years and under, his announcement was interrupted. Amen. The Frankham family is going to come read and sing to us. Go ahead, Mr. Frankham. Yes, please.
That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them, "Do not be afraid." He said, I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth lying in a manger. Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Oh my, glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those whom God is pleased." Thank you, Jesus.
Hark the herald angels sing.
It happens quite often that when we use these electronic things for chord charts, sometimes they just don't work out like they're supposed to. Amen. So, his birth. Amen. Angels sang. Hark the herald angels sing. Amen. Can you imagine what hell must have felt like when all the host of heaven showed up? You know, this is the thing. The enemy thinks he's got the key to your life. And he thinks he knows exactly he's got you right where he wants you. And all of a sudden, God shows up. Amen. When I always go back to it because it's my testimony and I love it. But first time I went into a church, amen, a spirit-filled church. And man, I was like, there's a devil in that church. I'll never go back to one of them as long as I live. And you know, the enemy thought he had me right where he wanted me. Because I ran out of that church like my hair was on fire. But what he didn't know is that pushed me to search. And the more I dug, the more I sought after God, the more God showed up. Amen. So I like this part. A screech rang out through the demonic hordes as the entire host of heaven, all of the angels of God, all of those heavenly beings came flashing through the regions of darkness on their way from heaven to a field just outside of Bethlehem. The accuser himself followed the brilliant light and arrived just in time to hear the choir that he used to lead in worship to Jehovah. Sing a new prophetic song. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, good will toward men. This is a revelation to a lot of folks. God's not mad at you. Come on, it is, he is, you know, people like, you know, no, you don't have to serve God. You can go to hell if you want to, but he has done everything to try to bring you in. He's not looking for a reason to keep you out. He is making a way to bring you in, amen. And I was talking to Anthony's dad about this Wednesday night when he came. You know, when a lot of us came, you know, what little church experience we did have, you know, it's like God's looking for an excuse to send us to hell. Oh, but friends, it's totally the opposite. He sent his son, amen. He is reaching into our lives, amen, to express his goodwill toward us. And friends, that's good news. Come on, I said that's good news. That's the word gospel means good news. God's good news, his goodwill for you and for me. Amen. So we have one more reading and a song by the Gregory family, the other Gregory family. I like that. I did put your names down here so we could keep that straight. Now, boys, I want to hear y'all sing on this one, all right? And I want to hear you sing on this one. And you guys watching the live stream, let's hear you sing on this one.
You want to read first or sing?
Oh, read first, please, yes. I'm bad about that, aren't I?
When the angels and returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. And seeing him, the shepherd told everyone what had happened and what the angels had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished.
Huh? How do you go to the next one? What? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me help you. Yeah. Two, three.
Joy to the world.
The Savior reigns. The song.
sing that first verse again. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Every heart prepare Him room, and heaven nature see, and heaven nature see, and heaven nature see. Woo! Amen. Thank you, guys. Hallelujah. Amen. That's the reason to shout. Amen. Those warring spirits of the Most High left the field and surrounded the little hovel closer into town. The light that shone from that area was so bright that it prevented any of the demon spirits from coming close enough to see what was happening. All of God's creation, angels of all ranks, territorial rulers, and demons and men all wondered at that sight. What does it all mean, they ask. Amen. There's another song that I have not practiced. I probably should have, but let's just sing part of it here. What child is this who laid to rest Mary's lap is sleep, who angels greet anthem sweet, while shepherds watch our keep. Come on, sing it. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste to bring Him all the babe, the Son of Man. Why lie He in such need this day, where ox and ass are feeding? Good Christian cheer, for sinners hear the silent word is pleading. Nails, speech, it shall pierce Him through the cross. What a day. Amen. What child is this? The Ancient of Days smiled from His throne. Even though the light shining from around that stable was a light normally out of human view, there were some on earth whose spiritual senses were keen enough to see it. The shepherds saw it, and they rejoiced and told their neighbors of the strange events that had just unfolded. His servant saw that light sometime later, when the parents of this young child came into the sanctuary to make offerings unto the Lord. The sight of this young child brought within this old man a sense of completion. Simeon knew his own assignment was completed now that Messiah had come. A widow named Anna saw the light also and began to prophesy to all that Israel's consolation had finally come. Hallelujah. The wise men followed that light for months until they came to the place where the young child was. Then these scholarly men who had been elevated to positions of leadership because of their wisdom and insight bowed low in worship directed at this young child, worship that befitted a king, the King of Kings. Yes, this event had been planned ever since the Holy Spirit hovered over the vast expanse of darkness that would become this little blue planet we call Earth. The Ancient of Days had kept the facts of this event hidden from the casual observer, but he whispered glimpses of it to his servants, the prophets. The one called Lucifer, never one to look too deeply into a thing, had missed the universal impact of this birth entirely. It is still amazing how the birth of one little child could so change the course of human history, that his birth would attract the attention of angels, demons, wise men, shepherds, kings, and priests. His birth changed my life. And if it hasn't already, it will change your life too, if you'll let him. Amen. This is Christ the King, whose shepherds guard and angels sing. Let's pray together. Amen. Father, we love you. Thank you for this Christmas season. And Holy Spirit, I just ask you now, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, let us forget about the gifts and forget about all of the hubbub of the holiday. And Lord, turn this day back into the holy day that you've always intended for it to be. A day when we recognize you have visited earth. Oh, God. And just as you came once, you are coming again. And Lord, I thank you for it. Let the revelation of Christ just be manifested in every one of our lives, in our minds, in our heart, in our spirit. And let us remember, Lord, that you're coming again for us real soon. We love you and thank you for all of these things. In Jesus' name, and the church said, amen. Can I get about four guys to come up here and give me a hand? Pass out, if you will, the communion emblems. They're going to hand out the communion emblems to you. If you would just hold them, we're going to receive communion together. While they're handing those out, I want you to be in prayer for Sister Dolores Tipp. If you don't know who that is, she sat right there every service when my dad was alive. Her and him would sit together, and she's in the nursing home, and they've called in hospice. Sandra's been over there and visited her, and I went earlier in the week, and she knew who I was. I went there yesterday, and she couldn't remember my name. So just pray for the Tipp family, and there are others. Amen. While we're receiving these communion emblems, just remember that there are families out there that are hurting. Amen. Hallelujah. This is Christ the King, whose shepherds God and angels sing. Haste to bring him long, the babe, the Son of Mary. This is Christ the King, whose shepherds God and angels sing. Haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Hallelujah. I'm going to just keep singing while they're handing these emblems out, but I want you to do me a favor. If y'all would just, if you've received, go ahead and stand and look around. If there's somebody sitting alone, don't let them. This is communion is a community event. Let's do this as a community. Amen. We're gonna take communion together, and then I'm gonna ask y'all to come up. We'll probably have to. There's a lot here tonight. We'll have to kind of spread out around, but we'll do this candlelight service to close out. Hallelujah. This is Christ the King, who shepherds God and angels sing. Haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Away in a manger, crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down. Sweet head, the stars in the sky look down where he lay, but little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus no crying he makes. Jesus, everybody, and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. We need to sing these songs more than once a year, don't we? Hallelujah. I want to thank you guys. Remember, tomorrow we'll be having service at 10:30. And there is no, everybody's like, why are we having, there's no pressure. If you have stuff to do, do your deal. We're going to come here and we're going to worship the Lord together. You're good. You're good. Hallelujah. I think we probably run out of communion services. Awesome. Just enough? All right. Hallelujah. Has everybody been served? Paul, right over here. Oh, awesome. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, my brother. Now, that very famous Christmas song, the reason for the season. Would you close your eyes and let's sing together before we take this. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved. Oh, yes. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, his mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. One more time. My chains are gone. That's why he came. I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, his mercy reigns. Oh, hallelujah. Amazing grace. Paul said, I've received of the Lord that said that the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread, he broke it, and he said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Let's eat together." And in the like manner, he took the cup after they had supped, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Drink ye all of this in remembrance of me." Hallelujah. Let's drink together. He said, "For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death." When? Until he comes again. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and love on him just a minute. Lord, we're looking forward to that soon return. Holy Spirit, I pray if there's anyone in here tonight that their heart is not right. They've been drifting right, left. They've got a long way from you. Lord, if there's any prodigals around tonight, Lord, I'm asking you in the mighty name of Jesus, let this be their night of visitation. Let this be the night when they realize that you are working behind the scenes. And God, you have already disarmed principalities and powers. And Lord, you have orchestrated this event in their lives so that they can be truly born again by the Spirit. Lord, have your way in their lives, in our lives tonight, is my prayer in the mighty, mighty, mighty name of Jesus. Guys, if you kind of dim those lights just a little bit, if you will. Here's what I'm going to ask you to do. I'm going to get a couple. Seth, if you'll come up here. And Hank, will you come up here with me, brother? Now, parents, if you have children, please stand with them. We're pretty proud of this carpet. All right. You don't have to lean it over. You just tilt it up like that. This is symbolic as well. It's illustrative of how we turn the lights on. Amen. So if you will, just kind of in the middle aisle, file up, and then just kind of peel right on back. Go ahead. Come on, get it, and then go right back to your seat, if you will. Gone are the days when we all could just circle up right here in the front. And yeah, you can get them, and then y'all just share the light. Just share it. Just remember, you don't have to turn them all the way over on the side. Silent night, holy night. All is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night. Shepherds quake at thy side. At the side, glory beams from heaven above. Heavenly hosts sing hallelujah. Jesus, Lord, at thy, boy, that was, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Silent, holy, take. Take over, please.
Round young virgin, mother and child,
holy infant, so tender and mild.
Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
Silent night,
holy night,
shepherds quake at the sight.
Kill those lights. We're going to sing this one more time. I want to go ahead and kill those.
Holy night.
Why don't you just hold those candles up?
All is calm.
All is calm. All is bright. Round yon virgin mother. Amen. Just hold those up. Let's pray. Father, come on, just give thanks. Lord, we give you thanks for this perfect gift. Lord, you have put a light in us as individuals, but in us as a church here on this corner. Lord, we're here to shine light into a dark place. And Father God, for every family, for every single family, those that are here, those that are watching the live stream, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, that, Father God, light will shine into every dark corner. That, Lord, whether they're prodigals or they're backslidden or whatever the situation is, Lord, that light shined into darkness. And, God, that men will come to the light. That, Lord, you will draw them. You will search them out. God, I pray tonight, Lord, that the peace of Jesus, the joy of Christmas, that, Father God, the hope and the love that you came to bring will just fill our hearts. Let tomorrow be a day of great celebration. I pray for reunions, that the hearts of the fathers are turning back to the children and the children to the fathers. Lord, you're a good, good God. We bless you and thank you and praise you for this Christmas. Lord, there might be a lot of bad news everywhere else, but in this house, Lord, we've got good news. God so loved the world that he gave. We give you thanks for it now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. The church said a great big loud.
Amen.
All right. Now, as you blow those candles out, that light, that's just a symbol. Amen? But the real light, I'm looking for that other basket. Y'all just go back there to the back. You can drop them off out there. The real light is what he put in you. Let your light so shine before men that they can see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. We'll be dismissed with this song. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is Lord. Merry Christmas. Well, go tell it. Tell it on the mountains, over the hills, everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain. The baskets are in the back. Take your candles back there.
Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year.